Here we have now an example that makes good use of what we just learned and shows you that it's actually this is relevant. So let's get started. We have two compilation units, unit1.c, which is on the left side, and unit2.c on the right side. So on the left side, in this unit1.c, we declare and define a global var. Basically, as we didn't put any further information, it's by default using external linkage. So that means this variable is available. So we can use throughout the code after it's declared. We can use global var. For example, here we print this value. Yeah, we set it to 10 in the main program. That all works. Now we have unit2.c and we try to compile it. Oh, we try to use global var as well. For instance, printing out its value. When we try to compile this code, we would get the message undeclared identifier. That means, typically, undeclared means it's not in the symbol table. And also we may want to use func here. When what is where is func defined? Well, it's over here in unit1.c. Here it's actually defined. So we want to execute from here the code over here, which is of course absolutely possible. To now make use of it in unit2.c, what you can do is, well, you can include those declarations. So we tell the computer system basically, here we have global var as an integer, and it knows, okay, this is, needs to be external linkage. And then we have int func. So that's basically the prototype for func without an implementation. Okay, and so in this case, as we have two times, we have it declared global var as external, and it's never initialized anywhere. It will be automatically initialized by the compiler to the value 0. So this example, while it works, has a little drawback that you have to know every time you have a C file, you have to know all those global variables and all those functions. Of course, we have for this purpose header files. So if we create a header file like unit.h, we can put here the global variables and the prototypes for the functions that we need. And now we can include those in both C files. Why do we use both? Well, we use both because we want to ensure that the definition of the function, for instance, has the same prototype as the usage. Okay? So it's really a good idea to do always use in header file in both the implementation and in the usage kind of case. Well, if we want to set, by the way, global var to a value, we could have done so in unit1.c, and then the compiler would have automatically used this initialization value.